The morning started out nice here on the Great Plains, but then the afternoon turned into a little bit of a showery day, which is fine. It's still kind of warm. Before the rain came, it was in the 80s. Now I'd say it's down into the mid 70s. So it's nice out. Tonight I'm going to a hockey game here in Wichita. The Thunder versus, I think it's Indianapolis. So, Indy Piper, we're coming after you. I think they're called the Fuel. I think that's what they're called. The Pipe. A nice rusticated EA Carry Magic Inch. I guess that's more of a sandblast than a rustication. Tobacco is Voodoo Queen. I think it's Sutliff. Been busy at work. I haven't quite got used to the second shift schedule. I'm usually staying up till about 2 or 3 in the morning, maybe a little bit later, and getting up around 11:30. Sometimes I don't feel tired because I'm getting plenty of sleep. I just feel like I should do more with my time that I have off. I'm sure I'll get used to the shift differences. But what I wanted to talk about today and the reason I picked the Voodoo Queen is because I want to tell you a spooky story that happened to me when I worked in the cemetery and funeral home business back in the early 2000s. Well, actually, it's two stories. It's two stories. And spooky might be a under not an understatement, but an overstatement. So I started right before Memorial Day in 2002. So somewhere beginning of May 2002. And what my job was to make phone calls to people and try to upsell them on, vaults and headstones and et cetera, et cetera. So pretty much if you already had a plot or a funeral plan with the cemetery that I worked for, I would call and try to upgrade your casket or what have you. So, right about, I'm going to say the Wednesday before Memorial Day of 2002, I'm in the office making phone calls. I call this lady's number. All these people are pretty much elderly, not too many people under the age of 40, if not under the age of 60. So this lady had to have been somewhere around I'd say 80 or 85, somewhere around there. I called a number. Young man answers the phone. I'm going to say he's late 20s, early 30s. And I asked for the lady. I was like, "Is Mrs. So-and-so there?" And he goes, "That's my grandmother." "Oh, well, is she home?" She goes, "She's been dead on the couch since Easter Sunday." So I said, "Okay, thank you very much." I get hold of my boss, Randy. I said, "Randy, I just called this number. The guy said his grandmother's been dead on the couch since Easter Sunday. This is towards the end of May, so I don't know how many weeks that would have been in that year, but you know, it's at least a month. So of course Randy calls the police. The police go to the house, find out that the lady is dead. She's been dead on the couch since Easter Sunday. I mean, just dead. So I was lucky enough to go with a guy that we had working at the cemetery named Blake to pick up the body. So we get there and the cops are talking to the young man over here in the corner. The paramedics came, of course, and they, you know, she's been dead, you know, no need for an inquest or anything like that. And she's decomposed pretty bad and she's on the couch. The smell is horrendous. Anyway, I guess he's been cashing her checks and her late husband. Social Security checks and pension and what have you since she passed. So he's going to jail on multiple counts of different things, I'm sure. Anyway, Blake and I get there and we can't pick the body up like you normally would. Well, we tried. So whenever you go pick up a body, you know, usually you wear something nice. Like I wore a sports jacket, a white shirt, and a tie, and a pair of slacks, you know. Blake, he wore something similar. But with this body being as badly decomposed as it was, we had to stick like a spine board underneath the cushions. So we slid it underneath the cushions of the couch that was holding her body, and we picked up and took the cushions and everything to put onto the gurney. And the smell, oh, gee whiz, it was awful, just grotesque. So we get the body. The remaining family decided the best idea would be to cremate because there was nothing less to have an open casket and all that. So we had that. We did that and all that. You know, I never really found out what happened to the young man that was watching the grandmother. And that was a creepy situation. But the creepiest thing that ever happened when I worked at the cemetery. Once again, we get a call. I go out to help Blake pick up the body. Recently deceased, not a month down the road, kind of deceased. We get there. We get the body on the gurney, etc., etc. We head back to the mortuary, and we take the body into the prep room, and they got this big slab that they put the bodies on whenever they come in. The funeral director was going to come in later that day. This might have been like a 7 o'clock pickup, if I remember right. So it was later in the day, so the mortician would have came in the next day, I believe, to get all the pertinence done and all that. Anyway, we put the body on the slab, on the table, and there's one light that's over the table that stays on all the time. It's not a, it's kind of a bright light, and the walls in the mortuary where I worked at were painted sea foam green, so it cast an eerie glow around the whole room. So we got the body up there, we got her laid out, and we got a sheet over the top of her. Her face is uncovered, you know, she's just laying there like a dead body lays there. So Blake leaves, I go out, I turn off the rest of the lights, I look back, and at that very moment in time, that body decided to expel a little bit of the gas that was still inside the body. It happens all the time. But you saw its, you know, you, I look back, I saw its lips move, its cheeks kind of puff, and make a little sound. Freaked me out. I mean, just flipped my lid. I never went on another call after that. You know, I didn't do this job long, less than 10 months. But that's my two scary stories or spooky stories that actually happened to me when I worked in the cemetery industry. Shortly after that, I went to work in the hardware business. I worked there for 11 years. Then I went to the hotel, and now I'm at the air conditioning factory. So that's my almost my whole 2000s work history there. When I worked at the hardware store, smoking pipes, I made this little tamper out of lamp parts. So. Ooh. This is a finial that goes on top of a lamp, like on top of your heart, and this is an extension. So if you have a longer lamp, then this will screw onto that finial cap, and then the finial will go on top of that. So I just made a pipe tamp out of two pieces of lamp hardware, just because I thought it was fun. Sometimes on a Wednesday night in the hardware business, it gets boring. So this is good stuff. I like it. It's a little bit spicy. It's got Perique, Virginia's, Burley, and something else. I can't remember. No casing. So I guess it's a vapor. Found my Zippo. I lost it. Then I decided to clean up stuff and I found it. On the back it says, "Fire, walk with me." I remember it from the original Twin Peaks, but I guess it's a song someplace, so I don't know. Anyway, thanks for listening. It's been a long video, but I hope you enjoyed the stories. And as Pipe Eye always says, I am what I am.